Smile, you're gonna die.
Hello, hello everybody. I have returned. The kingdom can be restored, finally, as it's meant to be.
I'm back. Sorry. I'm just gonna get right to the point. I'm not gonna ramble. Yeah, I probably am gonna ramble, but like, we might as well start off on the topic that I was planning on talking about, which is a story from my slut days. And I know that most of you think I'm a slut right now. Well, you'd be wrong. I'm a former slut. I was a slut, and then I discovered a god. And by god, I mean, 3D animated monster porn. I meet this dude on Tinder or something, and then we go to this bar, and it's pretty like chill, low key. He seems nice enough. I don't know, whatever. I had pretty low standards. So he takes me to this very, like, think of the most hipster party you could possibly imagine. And I've never been to a party like this before. Seemed like a warehouse. I don't really know what it was. Maybe people lived there. Different rooms for like different things. Like, there was a room where people were just drinking wine. There was like a room like with people painting. Like, there people were painting everywhere. There was just canvases, a microphone set up. People were just like saying shit in the mic. I don't know what people were supposed to be using that mic for, but I definitely got drunk enough to use it to sing happy birthday to someone. I'm not sure what exactly, but I was definitely up there talking to everybody. I think by the time we got to this party, I was completely just ignoring my date. We were all off. I was, when I drink, I just go around, talking to everybody and like just being fucking annoying, like I'm doing to you guys right now. I didn't know anybody here. It's a party. I told you this. I told you it's a party. And then, so at one point, this woman comes up to me and she's like, oh, did you come with that guy? I honestly could not even tell you his name because I don't remember it. She's like, there's something I have to tell you about him. And my mind is like racing. Like, there's so many possibilities of what she could tell me. Like, is he dangerous? Is he gonna kill me? But then just as she's about to tell me, someone calls her over and was like, hey, can you come here for something? And she's like, yeah, it'll be right back. But I never see this woman again. So he probably killed her is what I assume. I'm pretty sure I blacked out somewhere mid-party. As I used to. Honestly, I do not drink like this anymore. I can literally only handle 3 drinks, and on the 4th drink, I will puke. Like, I can't even feel drunk anymore because I feel sick before I even get to that drunk point, which is honestly good for me because I've done a lot of terrible, terrible things as an inebriated, intoxicated person. So let's not do that anymore. Another thing is when I would get really drunk and pass out, I used to piss myself. So you can tell where this story is going. I've pissed in my own bed multiple times. I've pissed in other people's beds. I've pissed on my roommate's couch at least a few times, which is why I don't have roommates anymore. We go back to his place and I'm blacked out, so I don't actually know where his place is. Like, I don't know how I got there. I don't know which area of town it is at all. I wake up, passed out on the bathroom floor, surrounded in many of my own fluids, including piss and puke. Those were the 2 main fluids. And the puke was not so fluidity. It was a little more chunky. It was on the chunky side. Maybe there were snacks at the party. I don't remember. I'm like hugging the toilet, like the base of the toilet. And my purse, actually. I have my purse with me and I'm also like holding that. And there's piss and puke in the purse. I've had piss in my purse at another time. Once my ex was like peeing in an alleyway and I was like, I like shelter him, make sure no one can see the dick. And then he just like turned to me and like pissed in my purse straight up. But I guess it was like getting me back for pissing in his bed. So it makes sense. I wake up like that. And then I go out and wake up and he's in his bed. He seemed like totally fine with all my piss and puke. Like, so many people are just fine with it, which I don't understand. Like, I should be reprimanded. Like, ew, what the fuck? You're a gross bitch. Like, never come here again. Like, I'd rather that happen than people be like, oh, it's okay, come here, let's fuck. And I'm like, dude, like, I literally just pissed and puked myself. Can you not try to, like, stick your dick in me right now? This is not the time. I'm going to puke in your face. He lent me this this long hippie tie-dye skirt. It's very colorful. Not something I would wear, necessarily. And then he's like, oh, and I have this sweater I can lend you, but it's my only sweater, so please, please bring it back. Oh, by the way, this is also the story about one of my biggest regrets. I know it doesn't seem like much, but I'm actually genuinely, like, I feel very guilty about this. So I wore the sweater and the skirt, like, I was trying to put them on his bed, and he was like touching me, and I'm like, dude, stop, like, go away. I'm gonna go now, like, I need to leave. I leave his place, I have no idea where I am. Turns out I have to walk like fucking half an hour to get to a metro is a subway. That's what we call them here in Montreal, because we're French. I'm pretty sure my phone was dead, so I was just walking in the bright, bright sunlight, picking puke out of my hair, which is actually fun. Like, I don't know why, I like picking things, so it was fun to have, like, crusty puke in my hair. Stop me. Holding a bag, like a garbage bag full of my pissed on, puked on clothes. It was a pretty disgusting walk of shame. Like, one of the most shameful walks I've had. Long story short, I block him because I don't want to see him again ever, to give him his sweater back. I felt bad about it, but I really, really did not want to see him again because I was extremely embarrassed and I still thought he might be a serial killer or something. So I ended up selling the sweater and the skirt because I needed to support my ex-boyfriend, and I was, you know, unemployed because my stupid video game testing job was not giving me hours. So I had to sell a bunch of shit to support him, okay? You gonna blame a girl for having to sell some random guy's favorite sweater to send money to her new boyfriend? No, don't blame me. Pay me. I feel bad, but moral of the story is, honestly, you figure it out. Okay, hey, so wanna see a record? I know that's the only reason you watch these. Here we have another fucking atmospheric black metal album because my taste is very specific. And especially at the time that I was collecting all of these records, I was literally like only listening to black metal, specifically atmospheric black metal, but I do have some other stuff. This is one of my all-time favorite albums. The disc might be blue, but this record is fucking gold. Look at this, it's like see-through. One of my most listened to albums. The sleeve is basic. So, Luster, Night Spirit. Oh God, just listen to all the Luster albums. It actually pairs really well with the 3D monster porn that I previously mentioned. Everybody do me a favor and go to a random hipster party tonight and puke on a stranger's bathroom floor and listen to Luster. Luster, Night Spirit, listen to it. Thank you and goodbye.